guys, Tropical Tim in the Philippines, in Palawan. But it won't be in Palawan much longer. No, I'm just taking a quick two-week jaunt up to Luzon, to Manila, to help my wife finish packing out our stuff, and then we'll be shipping that down here to Palawan. And just came through security, so you can see all the containers, and there's a pretty good size freighter, big open water freighter, all the containers down there. And this is where we are, Philippine Port Authority, Port of Princesa. Awesome. And there she is. Can I get that to go? That can I get that trip to Manila to go? No, that's I thought it was funny. That's what they call it. The company that runs these things, it's called to go. It's a pretty good sized ship. Not quite as big as the carriers I was on in the Navy, but for a passenger ship, not bad. I've actually never been on a passenger ship. Can you believe that? Been on a lot of ships, but never a passenger ship. Never no opportunity. My wife never begged me to go on a cruise or anything. I'm sure she'd go if I took her, but we're coming back on this boat too in 2 weeks. And she's worried about seasickness, and I said, give it a, just throw up once or twice, you know, puke once or twice, and you'll get your sea legs in no time. But we'll see what happens. Now, there is some minor concern, not on my part. I mean, you always think of it and put it in the back of your mind, but there's a pretty strong low system brewing off to the, well, let's see, it was off to the southeast. It already passed Guam, and it hadn't quite developed fully yet, but they thought it could. And then they said it kind of vectored north, so it's going to hit the tip of Luzon. So maybe Manila will be spared if it does turn into anything like a typhoon. But even a good tropical low can do some damage. So they're thinking, latest update I has was it might cruise to the northeast. Well, we're coming from the extreme southwest and heading north, but hopefully we don't run into any problems with that. But I'm ready. I'll rock and roll out at sea. It's all good. So do some more vlogging here when we get on board. And until then, peace out. It's pretty cool. And here we go. Boom, boom, boom. Hello.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
How are you?
Hey, sir. Good morning.
Hey, how are you? Morning. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Yeah, no problem. Hello. We're getting higher and higher. So there's your Port Authority. We just boarded the ship. Everyone's waving. They want to get on YouTube, that's all right. Well, it's been a while since I've been to sea. Let's see, at least, you know, 1999. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Looks like a big cargo bay, shipping bay kind of thing. Lots of boxes and containers, whatever, I'm guessing. And it looks like we got some members of the Philippine military here or something. Hi.
Hi. How are you, sir?
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you, too?
I'm fine.
That's good.
She's going to take good care of me here?
Yeah. Your accommodation is Mega Orange at second floor upstairs.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
How are you?
Okay.
Okay, so far everyone's been really nice. But you're in the Philippines, so everybody's expected to be nice. See, they're trying to see what my accommodations are. Hi, everyone's on YouTube.
Straight, turn left, turn right, straight ahead.
Thank you. Look at that, they even got things to eat here, some gifts. This should be pretty cool. This should be a pretty good experience. Wow. Now you're getting into it. Yeah, actually, I didn't have breakfast, so guess who's hungry? So this is going to be a lot of vlogging, no doubt, on this trip. So I think I'll probably break it down into a couple different sections. Wow. Hey, life vest. So this is pretty cool. Look at this. Absolutely awesome. Look at all the people here. You get free food. We know that. Three meals a day. Unless you want to go to a different restaurant and buy your own food. As far as I know. So, we'll just see how that works out. Okay, I'm going to go get settled in my stateroom or my assigned quarters. And I don't know, maybe while I'm here I can yeah, so you got bunk beds there, up and down. That's, you get assigned a room. And there's some more, pretty cool. Shared spaces like that. I wonder if I can hold a captain's mast while I'm out here. You know, just bring somebody to their knees and hold them accountable just for being, you know, a nice person, something like that. My goal is to drive this ship. I don't know if that'll happen. There you go, here's some more. Look at this big bay. Lots of bunk beds here, tons. All right, let me get something to eat and check in later, peace out. So I'm in this little restaurant eatery thing here and I'm gonna have some breakfast. This looks all, but this I have to pay for. The free stuff featured a hard-boiled egg, rice, and some mushed up tuna. Looking, it looked like cat food and probably tasted like it. I don't know, it was really, really bad. And I said, you know what? I don't want this, thank you. I know it's free. So I came in here and I should be able to do okay right here. Got some sausage, some eggs, rice if I want it. So very interesting so far. It's an adventure, peace out. So I'm actually in the Horizon Cafe and you can see some folks eating here. Apparently if you have a certain upgraded ticket, where you're in a single cabin, which is where I'm trying to get to instead of an open bay type scenario, you can come in here and eat for free your meals. But if you're not, you got to pay 175 pesos. So that's, you know, $3.50. And this is what I get for it. Got some, looks like some eggs with some, I don't know, bell pepper or something in it. Scramble, it's okay. Some chicken longanisa sausage, some rice, coffee. And I upgraded to a Gatorade. So I'm gonna go ahead and eat. I need to eat so I can get to my videoing and showing you guys some other things. So peace out. Okay, they're running some announcements as is the norm aboard any ship once you get underway. But hopefully you can hear me. I thought this would be cool to show you. They do have a phone charging area. So that's kind of cool. They've got the different different type plugs and jacks. That one looks like it's broken. But you pay some money. What is it? There you go. 5 pesos for 10 minutes. So that's not bad. Remember, 52 pesos to the dollar. So I'm pretty sure most of you can afford this if you need it. But you could do like I did and just bring your own charger, already charged up, ready to go, which I did. But just in case I even run out of that, this is available, so that's cool. Okay, so we're definitely underway. We're not haze gray and underway. That's a Navy term for those of you who've never been in the Navy or have no affiliation with it. Haze gray and underway, that's what we'd call it once we left Pierside or Anchorage. So this is bright white and underway, I guess, I don't know. Blue decks, but we're definitely out to sea now. Excuse me, moving further and further away from Palawan. As you can see, a lot of the boats in the harbor there. mountainous background. Pretty cool. Been a while since I've been out to sea, so this should be fun. Looks like some inclement weather. Don't know if we're going into it or it's heading away from us, or I don't really care. I always liked it when it rained out at sea a little bit anyway. We didn't have to work as much. We wouldn't have to chip paint, scrape rust, and repaint the decks because it was raining. No, but rain is a little cool sometimes. So I don't know which way we're going, but I think we're heading into that squall over there. That's cool. A little clear in the background there, but I think Port of Princesa and Palawan in general was scheduled for some rain anyway, so it is rainy season. It's official. Rainy season has launched. And you know, I didn't know this, but I was wondering, where did the term rainy season come from? Obviously it rains a lot during a specific time of year, but I kind of wanted to know more about it, and it is defined. You can look it up on different weather channels and things like that, AccuWeather, whatever. But rainy season is determined by a minimum amount of rain falling, and it has to be that same amount for a minimum amount of days, like, I don't know, a couple inches or whatever, half inch or an inch. I couldn't determine that. It was in meters and millimeters and all that other BS. But for three straight days. And trust me, I've been through enough rainy seasons in the Philippines to know they definitely qualify for that during rainy season. So I thought that was cool. Thought I'd share that. Hey, peace out. Hey, I'm back. Tropical Tim in the Philippines, and we're underway. There goes Palawan in the background. There's some more of it up ahead, of course. We're gonna cruise up to Caran. And I guess it's like an hour and a half, 2 hour layover there. They do not let you off the ship. Probably because you gotta go through so much security again to get back on, but that's all good. So I opted out of my the bed that I was assigned in like a common area where there's a whole slew of bunk beds, and kind of cramped in there. And you know, I said, you know what, let me go check out if I can upgrade. And of course, the boat's not full of passengers, and yeah, I was able to upgrade for another 850 pesos, so, you know, about 15, 16 bucks, and I got a four-man room instead of a 50-man room, whatever, but there's nobody else in my room, so I had to give up my driver's license so I could keep the key. But if passengers in Quran are assigned and already booked a bunk in my room, then I have to give up the key so everyone can get in and out. And well, there you go. But at least for now, from here to Quran, for another 16 bucks, I upgraded and I'm by myself. I did look at a private stateroom, and they're really nice. They got two queen size beds and private CR bathroom. But the cost of that just from Palawan to Quran is 2,350 pesos, and then if you want it again, it's another 2,350 from Quran to Manila. So that's, you know, better part of 46 bucks, 45 bucks, something like that, each time, both times you pay. So 90 bucks, I mean, maybe, I'm thinking about it. And so when me and the wife come back July 5th, I may opt for that. It's just a little bit more private, and you know, maybe it's worth the money. I'll see. So far, the food here on the ship absolutely sucks. I went for the free breakfast. You get a complimentary breakfast. Oh, actually, I think you get lunch, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And it's just a assembly line. They serve it to you. They plate it for you. It's not like a buffet. And they gave me it was a rice, which is natural. That's fine. A hard-boiled egg. And some mushy tuna thing, and I was like, absolutely not. It looked bad, it smelled bad, so I passed. And I went into the Seabreeze restaurant, and I showed you a photo of it. Don't eat there. That was not any better, and I had to pay 175 pesos. Now, for my upgrade to the room, I get to eat in there for free. but I'm not so sure. I think I may just visit the snack shop and do that kind of thing. I was going to pack munchies, but my brother-in-law, who has made this journey many times back and forth, Palawan and Manila, told me, no, you don't need to do that. There's a lot of food here. It's free and yada, yada, yada. I'm like, yeah, you know what? I should have packed some munchies. So, but my lesson learned is your gain. There you have it. But maybe the food will get better with a different meal. I don't know. I'll check it out. But if not, they've got plenty of snacks and stuff in the snack shop. So I'll be good to go. Really nice here. Out to sea. Man, it's been a while. This is awesome. There was a little rain earlier. Seems to have passed. There's the, what we call the stack, smoke stack. That goes all the way down to the engine room, I'm sure. So, yeah, you don't see too many people out on deck now since we've gotten underway. A lot of them are laying down, and probably to avoid seasickness or motion sickness, who knows. I can't believe this early in the day, and it's only about 8:30, 9 a.m., that all those people are tired. I just don't buy that. So I think they're just trying to avoid the motion up here on deck, and that's fine. They got to do what they got to do. So here we are, out in the South China Sea or the West Philippine Sea. I'm not sure which part is which, but pretty cool. So I'll tune in and check in with you a little later. Peace out. Okay, so here's another bank of recharging stations. Looks like slot machines. I wish it was. That'd be cool. Give me something to do. Who knows? Maybe if I put 5 pesos in here, something, maybe I'll hit. I doubt it. So let's take a look at one of the big massive bunk bays. So I would venture to say there's about 125 beds in there, and that's what I originally purchased. I didn't know that. I just heard the word mega. I'm like, yeah, that sounds cool. Little lounge area here. So again, I made a mistake. Like I said, hey, welcome aboard. My mistake, or my lessons learned, you can benefit from it. If you ever wanna come aboard this and travel around some of the islands here, they've got designated like that. And they also have it for the males, of course. There goes a couple guys in the male one. So that's cool. Now, oh, there's some workers there.
Oh, hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel.
Hi, hi. Hello. Oh.
What's your name in your YouTube channel?
What's your YouTube channel, sir?
Tropical Tim in the Philippines.
Ah, okay.
Let's search for it, sir.
You should.
Hey, yeah, search for it.
See all my vlogs in the Philippines.
Yeah, yes, yeah. Please subscribe it.
You should. What's the name of it?
Tropical
Tim.
In the
Philippines.
Yeah.
In the Philippines.
In the Philippines.
Okay.
Later, sir.
Okay, so here's my room. I'm all by myself. So that's pretty cool. Got my own key. There we go. 207 cabin. And they're working. And this is what a 4-person room looks like. Now I opted for this because they said, hold on, let me turn this TV off. There we go, it gets 4 channels. ESPN, ESPN2, Fox News, no, I'm kidding. It gets 4 channels. Who knows how well they'll hold up as we get further out to sea, and they're all Tagalog, Philippine channels, so that's cool. So this is what a, a four-person cabin looks like. It's not bad. Not bad. Got some privacy curtains and a view of the planet. There you go. Here we are, out to sea. So this isn't too bad. Here's the other side. And there you go. Couple little ladders to step up on and a bunk. This is supposed to be some kind of stereo or something. It doesn't work. I've tried everything. Well, maybe it does work. I'm trying to... Nothing. Down here, some life jackets. And let's see, it comes with a pillow and a blanket. Privacy curtain, of course. So, pretty cool. I'm just going to chill out in here just for a little bit, catch my breath, and we'll be on our way. There is a, I guess you can call this a private bath with shower. So that's cool. But it really stinks in here. Can't tell you why, but it smells. But, you know, make the best of it. So that would be for four people sharing. And again, they do have the absolute private staterooms if you want to pay. And they are nice. But I'm gonna consider that for my next trip when we come back. So there you have it. This is my home for roughly 22 hours. Peace out. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and use one of these. I have my regular charger, but I'm going to save that for my phone. This is my little pocket Wi-Fi, and I guess when I packed up my bag this morning, I forgot to shut it off, so over this last few hours or whatever, it crapped out, and I don't even think it's going to work out here out at sea, but I need to find out, I want to try it, and see if I can't pull up something on my phone, sports scores, whatever, things like that. So let's go ahead and see how this works. 5 pesos right there. Okay, and I get 10 minutes of charging, and lo and behold, it went on. So that's cool. We'll let it count down and see how that works out. Don't think I need this extra 5, so we'll put that back into my little bag here. And I really gotta tell you about this. This is a... Let me turn the camera around. Shoulder bag. And there I am. And I never thought I would have one of these. I don't know what they call them. European shoulder bag. But my wife bought it for me and insisted I try it instead of carrying everything in my pockets here and in my back pockets. And I got a lot of stuff. You know, I got a couple phones, I got my charger, I got my pocket Wi-Fi and my wallet and a lot of stuff. And it's really cool. It's got a compartment back here. It's got 1, 2, 3 and an extra security one right there. So I'm getting used to it. I have to admit, I thought it was kind of feminine or whatever to carry it. What do they call it? What's that again? Over the European shoulder bag or whatever. But I'm finding it's convenient and quite secure, because you carry it in the front of you, kinda. There's kind of what it looks like more. And it's nice, it's okay. I'm getting over my phobia of looking kind of feminine or whatever wearing that. But it's definitely working. I keep it over me and I can wear the bag right in front of me, so it's kind of cool. Thought I'd share that with you. Never thought I'd wear one. But definitely working. I can carry my money, my wallet, everything, and keep it right here in front of me. So I kind of like that. We're still counting down here, so I'll finish that and get back to you. Peace out. So this is pretty cool. The fine folks that work on the boat here, they come around and they're offering champurrado.
Champurrado and siopao.
And siopao.
Yeah, siopao, chicken asado.
Wow, isn't that nice? You're going to be on my YouTube channel, Tropical Tim in the Philippines. So that's pretty cool. They come around and offer that. Nice deal. That's a good deal. Thanks for sharing that with
me.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir.
That was pretty cool. Let's check out my charging. Getting there. One quick observation here. When it first came aboard this morning, there's nothing but people everywhere. But now that we're underway and away from land, you can't hardly see anyone. They're all in their bunks or somewhere, but come chow time, you'll see them all again down on the first deck, the main deck, and but it's like a ghost town. The hallways are all yours. You can cruise around and walk around and do whatever you want, but everyone's in their bunk, I think, either catching some Z's. Look, they've got SpongeBob SquarePants going on there. Yep, everyone's chilling out, just doing their thing, so very scarce to see people in the hallways right now. Don't know why. Okay, so right now, we are gonna go check out the sun deck. Hi. Up some more stairs. Watch your step, please. I'd like to get to the bridge and or the engine room. Don't know if that'll happen. I'm gonna put it at a slim to none, and Slim just left town, but that's all right. But here we are up on the sun deck. A little more clear right now, not much. Still pretty overcast, and just cruising along the coast of Palawan until we get to Caran. And if anyone doesn't know, Caran is an island located just northeast off the main coast of Palawan. I've never been there. And technically, I'm still never gonna actually be able to say I was there, because we're gonna tie up there, probably, you know, like I said, to let people on and let people off. But we're not allowed to get off because we're only there 90 minutes or 2 hours, and well, there you go. So I can kind of say I was there, but I'll get there. I'm planning a trip there anyway, so that's pretty cool. Pretty good sized boat, like I said. No sea swells. Sea's quite calm right now. Of course, that can change in a minute. Pretty good size. And again, I've seen the big cruise ships, and they look massive just from what I see on TV or pictures. So I don't think this one really compares to those, but it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. And there's some more. All right, I'm gonna work on trying to get into the engine room or to the bridge. And like I said, I think that's not gonna happen, but I don't know. I've been known to pull off some things in my time. We'll see how it works out. Of course, I'm gonna try to sell them the opportunity to get on my YouTube channel and meet all you folks out there in TV land. Let's go see how that works out. Peace out. So, if you're not busy and you think you woke up with a bad hair day, they even have a salon here. So, hello. How's everybody? So, look at that, see? Can get your hair done here?
Yeah.
Hi, how are you? You're gonna be on my YouTube channel.
Yes.
So that's pretty cool. Who would have thought that? A little salon right here out in the middle of the ocean. Don't believe me? There's the middle of the ocean. Pretty cool, huh? Well, thanks for letting me stop by. I appreciate it. Oh, they're gonna wash the hair and everything, huh? That's pretty cool. Let's check it out for a minute. Nice. You having champurrado? There's the free champurrado. Oh, is it good? Yeah. And there she goes. She's starting to work on her. I'm sure it's going to come out looking great. I know it feels good though, right?
Yeah.
Anytime somebody washes your hair for you, it feels good, you know? Well, thank you again. Have a great day. So that was pretty cool. And this is the main dining room. They're playing music. Loud. It's karaoke. Look at that. And it looks like they're setting up for the next meal. Look at that. Chapao. Chapao. If you don't know what that is, it's a very light, fluffy steam bread with egg and meat in it, like pork or beef or whatever. So, looks like they're, the crew is setting up. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Say hi. Hi. There she is again.
It's my big pencil.
Look at the size of that pencil. That is awesome. Let me see. No, you go ahead.
I made it.
Can you write something?
Yes. What do you like to write?
So that's pretty cool. Look at that. Now that's a pencil. Wow. Put your John Hancock right there. Awesome. Oh, it's even got a little clip so you can clip it to your... Nice. Thank you. So they're getting all the rice ready, all the food for the next meal. There's some more of the free champurrado. Champurrado is like chocolate rice. That's all I call it, chocolate rice. I'm sure it's a more defined than that. But for me, I just call it chocolate rice. I'm not a big fan of it. I taste it. It's okay. I could eat it if I had to. No big deal. But my kids growing up loved it. My wife made it for them, and they absolutely loved it. So we'll leave them, get back to work. Karaoke is still going on here. That's the great thing about Filipinos. They just think they've got great voices, and many of them do, believe it or not. But I mean, especially after a couple drinks, watch out. You're going to have a good time. So here's the little Quick Mart gift shop kind of thing. Let's see what they got in here. There's some of the employees. Hi, how are
you?
There they are. Welcome to my YouTube channel.
Welcome to the Philippines.
Thank you.
It's more fun.
That's what I tell them. But I live here, so I'm telling everybody about it, you know. So they've got different soups for you if you want. Crackers, snacks, chips, you know, and a host of goodies. And what is that? Oh, that's junk. That's no good. Powerade sodas. What is that? Well, that sucks. Definitely can't be doing any of that. Whole bunch of chips and crackers and waters, and look at her shelves, kind of shaped like little dinghy boats or something. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. More snacks for you. So you can't go wrong. There's a variety of things here. Cold drinks, but you know what? Coolers in the Philippines, I don't care where you go, seldom are they cold. Yeah, they're cold, but they're not ice cold, so that's up to the individual. I like all my drinks ice cold, but I do like room water. Wait a minute, what's this? That's no good. That ain't any good. Booyah! Look at that. You kidding me? Really? I hope this boat ride lasts for like 5 days. Again, not very cold, but hey, you know how I always say it, if you can't hit the curveball, sit on the fastball. We'll take it. Just to relax and kind of chill out for a minute.
Bye.
Oh. Go ahead, sing it.
No.
Let's hear it, it's okay. Somebody might discover you as a star. You might be a big star.
That's 87.
87? That's pretty reasonable. Not bad for being out on a boat. It would probably be 287 if it was a casino. Sorry? Oh, look what I get with it, free. Not bad. Thank you. Ah.